Heather, my daughter, was 26 when she died, which was almost almost 5 years ago. That was 2nd of December 2005, as she took her own life. Actually, she had attempted to do so like 5 days earlier. She was on life support for 5 days. So, effectively, you know, we lost her on the 27th of November. It was the 2nd of December when she died. So it's like a whole, it was a whole week of absolute hell, you know, from when she was admitted to hospital until, you know, eventually then that she died, 5-6 days later. So, the dates were significant, and as much as it was my mother's birthday when she attempted to take her own life, or took her own life, because effectively that's what she did on that day, but she didn't actually die then until my sister's birthday. So, so both dates were indelible in my mind anyway. And my sister's still alive. She's my eldest sibling, so it's obviously a date now of far more significance to me now, of course. Well, Heather had an ongoing problems with addictions, and she had various attempts to get clean and free from alcohol and other substances. And so she had, unfortunately then she had a history of substance abuse. And despite not all the best intentions of everyone and anyone who loved her, cared for her, she was unable to refrain from. She did have some periods. She had 18 months or so up at one stage where she was gluten free, but unfortunately that didn't last. And so she was a client then of the mental health services, and unfortunately I don't think that the harm minimisation, which seems to be the new thing these days, I don't believe is an effective way to treat people with addictions. I believe that total abstinence is the only way to go, and consequently her visits to hospital, I don't believe were treated with in the way that they ought to have been done for someone in a state like, in a condition like that. At the very end, despite her treatments of, you know, various times, she's gone to hospital, and either through harm, when she had harmed herself, I don't believe there was any real serious attempts on that she had attempted on her life before, but she did harm herself, you know, cut her forearms and things like that. And the mental health system, I felt, let her down. In fact, at the end, 2 days before she died, she was fearful for her own safety. She called the police, who took her to hospital. And she was admitted to hospital late on Friday night. Because, as I said, she was concerned for her own safety, and she was well, I don't know whether it was technically admitted to hospital, but she was in hospital all night, and was discharged the following morning with a bottle of pills, and saying that we'll call you. And within 24 hours or slightly more than that, they did call her. They called her the following morning, and they were the last people to speak to her before she took her own life. within an hour of him talking to the cat team on the phone, she hung herself. And unfortunately, she was rescued and cut down, but unfortunately by that time the damage had already been done to her brain, lack of oxygen, and so for 5 days she was on life support. And eventually the machines were switched off and she lasted another 2 hours after that before she died. I think that's a hard question to answer in a way, really, because each case is individual. I would be saying to them that I have an understanding of where you come from, because I have had a similar thing, but I don't really exactly know how somebody else feels. Nobody does. Each person we grieve in different ways, and our relationships with our deceased child, the sibling, are different. Every case is different. But I would be encouraging them to be able to find out about grief and to tap into a support network, like I have done with Compassionate Friends, and been able to read literature about grief and realise that how they're feeling is normal, and that it's okay for them to feel that way, and that they're not themselves not feeling, or their feelings are normal. The way they feel, whatever they might be. We go through a whole range of feelings: anger, fear, resentment, blaming, self-worth, blaming other people. There's all sorts, a whole range of emotions that you can go through, and you can do so in a 5-minute period. You go through the whole lot of them. You can just change so dramatically, but that these are normal. These are normal feelings and normal reactions, and but just being able to make contact with other people that are in a similar situation is tremendous. We understand this, perhaps few others can, and so I would encourage anybody like that to tap into that facilities that are available there. There is hope for from my viewpoint of coming to terms with what's happened. Obviously, there's no hope of changing it. There's nothing so permanent as death. There's no hope of changing that. However, there is hope of being able to deal with the consequences of that. And I feel that people who are newly bereaved don't necessarily see that. Nor do they necessarily want to hear it either, because in their grief, and it's an important part, of course, of grieving, is feeling the feelings. Today, I like to think I can feel the feelings, and I can cope with that and deal with that now. I know what they are now. I'm missing my daughter. It might hit me just like that, where walking down the street, and I'll see someone with a similar gait, or my daughter had distinctive long curly red hair, so she stood out in a crowd. And if I see someone with a similar hairstyle, it's almost like, oh, there's Heather, and it'll hit me for a minute. So, but I realise that it's good to have these memories, these golden nuggets, these golden memories. And when I do see that, and sure, I might feel, oh, there's Heather, but I also know that that's these golden memories that I have of her, and that I hope that I never let go of. So, I find that in time I learn how to deal with it, how to cope with the grief, and just overcome it. I always miss your child. It's not the normal course of events for you to bury your children, but I am able to accept that now, and accept the things that I can't change. It doesn't mean to say that I like it, but I can accept the things that I can't change, and you can't change death.